I'll start off by saying that my mission was the best mission in the world. We have this slide like for new coming missionaries that says that. And because we have both province and city in our mission, we have an island in our mission, Mindoro, and it's absolutely gorgeous. The beaches there are just breathtaking because the water is just pure clear and it's just awesome. And let's see, we have about, when I left, we only had, I want to say 150 missionaries. It's grown to about 200, I've heard. And our goal was to hit 100 baptisms a month when I left. And this past December, I believe they hit around 180 in the month of December. And so President Revillo has raised that number to 200 a month now for 2015. And that may seem a lot, but in the Philippines, people are very receptive to the gospel, and especially because you're in city, in the Quezon City, there are so many people in a small area. So your area as a missionary may be extremely tiny, like distance-wise, but you have more people than you would have like in a city here in the United States, simply because Filipinos just live, I don't know the English word, dikit, which I don't know how to explain, just close, basically, in English. Another unique thing about our mission is the leadership. President Revillo is very particular about leadership and stuff, and he really believes in training missionaries, and so there's a lot of fun training meetings that you'll have, and President and Sister Revillo are amazing. They will walk you through things. They'll talk to you about if you're having problems or anything. They'll come with you to like different areas and they'll teach with you in these homes, and it's amazing to watch them. We had Sister Revillo on a lesson, and it's amazing to see their testimonies and the works of things. And they're all about getting in there with you, which is awesome because you just learn from these amazing people. We had senior couples in our mission. That was a blessing. They helped out a lot. Most of our areas had churches, but it's different. In the city, we were a lot more built and there were a lot more members than in province areas, like farm areas. But there were still some areas that I knew elders that served in, they would just have meeting houses because there weren't enough members yet to actually have a church. And it depends how much tithing the members are paying. If they're being faithful in doing that, then they're able to fund the actual building of more churches. Quezon City is blessed to have the Manila Temple in our mission. I was actually able to serve in that area, which was amazing because we were able to teach our investigators on the grounds of the temple. And with permission from President, you can bring your investigators to tour the temple. That was a huge missionary experience for us in that mission, because in all of Quezon City and all the neighboring cities like Pateros and just all these other cities that were around where the temple was, you would have people, you would talk to them on the jeepneys or in taxis, and they would say, "Oh, Mormons, yeah, you have that huge church on top of that hill in White Plains." And we'd be like, "Yeah, that's our temple." And they're like, "What's the difference between a temple and a church?" And we'd explain to them. And they're like, "Oh, it's so beautiful because of the pollution in the Philippines, sometimes it's the buildings get really dirty. And so even if it's like a nice looking building, there'll be like black smog all over it. And so obviously with our temple, it's different because it's so white and they keep it white and they have the angel Moroni. And so everyone's always like, "Oh, it's so maputi, it's so white." And they're like, "We just want to go in it." I had one investigator, he told us, he's like, "Sister Wilson, I drove past it in the taxi and I was having the worst day of my entire life. I was so upset. And then I just saw the temple and I thought, I need to go there. I'm going to go there one day." And we took him on a temple tour and it was awesome. He just felt the spirit so strong. And so that's a huge blessing that most of the other missions don't get. And you'll be able to do an endowment session every transfer, which is another blessing. Yeah, it was really nice. And I love that personally, just because you get to know the covenants a lot more. And it's a really good break to just reflect on yourself and pull yourself together.